What do you understand by term judicial notice? What are those facts of which a court can take judicial notice? Answer. Chapter 3 of Indian Evidence Act deals with facts which need not be proved. Section 56 of the Act declares no fact of which the court will take judicial notice need be proved. Judicial notice meaning. Some of fact need not be proved because the court itself will take judicial notice of them if they are relevant. Certain facts are so notorious in themselves or are stated in so authentic manner as well-known and accessible publications that they require no proof. The court, if it does not know them, can inform itself upon them without formally taking evidence. These facts are said to be judicially noticed. For example, if it becomes relevant in a case to know as to who is the President of India, a party need not to adduce any evidence to that effect. Install of Travancore, Tiruppa Brand V, K, Vinay Chanderan and others, AIR 1989 Kar. 302, it was held that all notifications of a legislature are equivalent to law. The notification in question is proviso of section 34 and court is bound to take judicial notice of this fact US 57 of Indian Evidence Act. In order to understand the correct meaning of sections 56 and 57, they should be taken together. Section 56 lays down that when a fact, which is relevant in a case, is of such a nature that the court must take judicial notice of it, no evidence in proof of it should be given. Section 57 gives a list of facts of which the courts must take judicial notice of. Thus, both the sections taken together mean that when controversy arises with regard to the facts enumerated in Section 57, the parties who assert their existence need not produce any evidence to prove the existence of such fact. However, matters enumerated in Section 57 do not form an exhaustive list. The court could take judicial notice of other facts not to be found in the list. It was observed in Nityanand etc. v. SGPC Amritsar, 1992, 1, RCR 406, P&H, DB, that under Section 57 of the Evidence Act, the court may presume that any book to which it refers for information on matters of public or general interest was written and placed by whom or at which it purports to have been written or published. In questions of public history, the court can only dispense with evidence of notorious or undisputed facts. But before any judicial notice could be taken of any passage in books relating to the alleged tradition, something more than the mere existence of the passages would have to be proved before the passages could be regarded as evidence of the existence of the tradition. It must be shown that the writer had any special knowledge of the alleged tradition, or that the tradition is a repetition of that given in the history. Then Section 58 of the lays down that if parties to a proceedings or their agents agree to admit a fact at the hearing, or which they agree to admit by writing before the hearing, or which by any rule of pleading in force they are deemed to have admitted by their pleadings, it need not be proved by the opposite party.